Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, officials and experts. I'm very pleased to be here today to spend the morning with you. Actually, the investment was in euros. It is really a great honor to see so many of you have found your way to the Tallinn e-governance conference. So, welcome to Estonia, or should I say to e-Estonia. Building e-Estonia as one of the most advanced e-societies in the world has involved continuous experimentations and learnings from our mistakes. Luckily, we have often succeeded. I am sure that you already know examples like this. 96% of us declare taxes online. It takes less than 5 minutes. No need for tax advisors, no additional costs. We have a nationwide electronic health register together with digital prescription. It means less need for extra visits and time spent for waiting at doctor's office, which also means we save time and money, both us and doctors. Or Estonia was the first country and still is really the only in the world to introduce internet voting. About a third of votes are cast over internet, making democracy more accessible. And there are plenty of examples like this. We are proud of our achievements because of the great impact that digitalization has brought to making us, as a small country, more efficient and effective, transparent and accountable. We have also made it easier for people and entrepreneurs to lead their lives and businesses, saving them time and money and opening new opportunities. We are also proud that Estonian digital governance has been recognized internationally. World Bank, in its 2016 World Development Report, called Estonia as one of the few countries that is truly on the road of becoming a digital society, and used our experience to draw some wider policy lessons to follow. For example, the importance of both legal framework and technical infrastructure when introducing digital identity and exchange our government data. I mean here X-Road. The Estonian government has been at the forefront of this development, introducing innovative e-governance solutions since early 2000s. Estonia has proudly been a pathfinder in building digital society and government, trying out new technologies and services. At the same time, we have not done so for the sake of technology. Instead, we have always tried to pragmatically solve practical problems. For example, we have proven that people do pay more taxes with the help of digital solutions. It has been our policy that we do not build digital solutions in isolation. We collaborate with the best minds and practices of private sector, our IT industry. That is why Estonian tech companies and experts, including e-governance academy, have unique know-how on how to digitally transform governments. They are more happy to partner with other governments or with companies from other countries to transfer know-how and maximize local knowledge and manpower. I would say even the girl power. Estonian experts have met, trained, consulted close to 100 governments in the world about various aspects of digitalization, from strategy and policy to concrete applications. There are solutions built by Estonian experts from Mexico to Moldova, from United Arab Emirates to Ukraine, from Namibia to Norway. By the way, if you still have not done so, do check out the exhibition area that supports this event. Various Estonian IT companies are presented there, showcasing the solutions they have developed and are happy to discuss how to transform these to your countries. The collaboration they can offer will be rooted in best practices from the government of Estonia. They can actually build better solutions than the Estonian current ones, because they have already experiences. Do note that they cannot do the full job for you. Our experts can only help and assist. Finally, the challenge of digital transformation is not the digital or technical part, but the transformation part. In order to use the full digital potential, governments need to change their internal functions and also how they offer public services. Such transformations need great leadership, careful change management, and often even reform mindset. And this takes courage, courage to accept risks and to try out new solutions. For example, when Estonia started with online voting in 2005, nobody had done it before, and many said it cannot be done securely. We decided to focus on how to do it instead of focusing on all the reasons why it cannot be done and have been voting online securely ever since. Indeed, sometimes we just need to start experimenting, especially in governments. We surely need to manage risks to acceptable level, but we cannot manage them all away. Sometimes we just need to start doing things and fail fast, learn fast, improve fast. Just like best startups do. If we remain too slow in governments, we will miss out opportunities and we will not be able to engage our citizens, especially the digital ones. Because of them, a digital government is the only acceptable government. This brings me to the main topic of current governance. To my mind, engagement is based on a link between partners, a relationship, and respect. If government are not online, or our digitally behaving citizens, and we will have them more and more, growing up every year, and businesses will not respect us, that reduces the link, our relationship with citizens and businesses and their engagement. Among other things, this means that we have to constantly keep working on digital services and governance. The work of improving government, and that includes the digital government, never ends. Estonian vision for next stage of digital government is simple. We should aim for zero bureaucracy and invisible government services. The best, the most citizen-centered service is the one you do not have to do anything for, where everything gets taken care for you before you even realize you need it. Technology already exists for such solutions today, starting from our own X-Road that allows to bring the relevant data together for such automated, seamless, proactive service delivery. We just need to redesign yet again how we work and provide services in our government departments. For example, in Estonia, the government knows when a child is born. As hospital creates the population registry entry for the newborn, we could proactively congratulate and thank the parent for the new citizen with a simple official email and ask two things. What's the name and what account you want the child's benefit to be sent to? That's all we need to provide the services. No need for new parents to hassle with applications, although they are already in online today. People don't have to spend any time really to be done with the things they need. That should be our goal. This is the experience that the digital citizens expect. That is the experience that has a chance of keeping them engaged with the state. Looking for the business perspective, we are working on an initiative called Reporting 3.0, led by the Estonian Tax Office. The aim is to give small and medium-sized enterprises an opportunity to get rid of their tax accounts as their clearing taxes and everyday reporting becomes fully automatic, if companies will consent to giving government access directly to their digital financial records. Then, never ever, we would bother them with red tape of reporting again. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope that this conference provides you food for thoughts, as well as useful contacts to move in similar directions in your countries. I want to sincerely thank the e-Governance Academy, your hosts and event organizers for continuing the tradition of the event. I also want to thank you all for working the time for discussions, for taking the time for discussions. We always welcome you back to Estonia, whether to learn more about our digital ways or building the next digital solutions together. As I said before, Estonian IT industry and experts are eager to work with you to create a digital future for your countries and for the world. Thank you very much and have a wonderful conference. I hope that still you will have time also to go outside from the dark rooms to look around, to enjoy our beautiful capital, and always welcome back. Thank you very much.